Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, giving you weekly tips and tools to get organized and get prepared. In this video, I'm going to show you my home fire emergency go bag. When there is a fire in your home, you want to get out, stay out, and call for help. So if you're putting together this kit, make sure that you have the basics in place, and then you can always add to it. If you live in an area that is prone to wildfires, you may want to have one that's a little bit different, also specifically for wildfires. This video is not comprehensive about fire safety and fire prevention, but you do want to have a fire safety, fire escape plan in place and practice that at least twice a year with your family or your roommates. And a good month to do that is September, which is National Preparedness Month, and also in March, which is spring cleaning. Make sure to have smoke alarms in each of your bedrooms and in the common areas of your home, like the kitchen, family room, and living room. Check those smoke alarms at least once a month. Make sure that the batteries are fresh and that it's working. There's a way to test your smoke alarms. You can also do that on the 1st or 15th of the month or when you pay your electric bill. So for us, that's the 8th of the month. That's also the time I check the air filters for our vents. And since I'm looking up already, that's when I check the smoke alarms. So this is under my bed on my side. And this is a fire escape kit from Go Time Gear, which has great reviews. So this is what I got. Then I have this bag. This is my emergency home fire go bag, and then I have a pair of shoes. So if there's a fire, I usually don't have shoes up here or slippers, so I just have this under my bed that I can just grab like this. It does have a pair of socks. These are just old shoes that are still wearable and are still good, so I chose to have those. If you're in an area where you need more like terrain, then get shoes that are appropriate for your area. This bag is from Go Next, and I chose this because it's lightweight. It's meant for day packing. And the great thing about this is that it already has this whistle right there that is attached to the bag. The other thing is that this can fold into itself, so it can just be like a compact bag. I just have this unzipped so it's easier like that. And then I have the handle that I can pull out this way. So just think of those little things when you're setting up where you're gonna put your emergency go bag. And then we could just flip it open. It has this. I have it facing here where the open latch is, and it looks like this. This kit also has fire resistant gloves, a glow stick, and an emergency blanket. All right, so this bag is underneath my bed like this, and I have it facing this way so that I can just grab the handle up here and pull it from under the bed. I do have the zipper open just a little bit, so that's just less things to unzip. And just make sure if you have a bag like this with this flap that covers the zipper, that you just go ahead and open the flap so that the zipper doesn't get stuck for any reason when you're in a hurry, okay? Then it just opens like that. Let me show you what's inside first. So just like in my fire escape kit, I have goggles and a dust mask. This is a less expensive alternative, but it does help a little bit and can buy you some time. On the outside, I just have this. It has a compass, it's a paracord, and it has a little tool here and a whistle. Can you see this tool? It's like a little knife. Okay, so since this bag is meant to be a day pack, it does have some reflectors here, over here. Can even add a reflector sticker there if you want. This backpack already weighs 9.4 pounds with everything in it, so you have to be aware that with any type of go bag that you're able to carry that amount of weight and for however long distance you think you will be going. So since I live in a suburban area, I have my car or I have friends nearby, it may not be a long distance that I'll be going, so 9.4 pounds is okay for me. If you happen to be in an area where you're more secluded or there's a rougher terrain, you just have to consider that. Okay, on this side, most backpacks, this is typical where you have a place to carry a bottle of water or a water bottle. So this one happens to be collapsible and it has this wrist band here. And so once this water is out, this can roll up and it's pretty nice there. On the other side has another pocket, mesh pocket, and that's where I keep this headlamp. It's the same one that we use for the home fire escape kit. And this particular one has the strap that goes over your head. So I thought that would just be more secure. And it also has a red light and it also tilts up and down like that. Okay, so that's the white light, brighter. Here's the red light flashing and then off. As I mentioned, we experienced a home fire. We had to be out of our apartment for a week and we were able to stay with a friend. So luckily we had friends in the area. If you don't, you have to make plans for that. And here in this upper pocket that is zipped, I just have some food. So some dried pineapple and a couple bars. So I figured this is good enough for a day. You know, one bar per meal and then my snack. And then in this front pocket, it opens up like this. And there's a zippered mesh area and then kind of a pocket in the back. And so in the pocket in the back, I have a flashlight and a glow stick. These I got from Costco, but I'll link similar products in the description box. And what I like about this is first, you can put this around your neck. It's a flashlight. And it also blinks like this. And then this is just your typical flashlight. This one's pretty strong. And then I have my whistle, okay. So like I said, it's a good thing that that paracord has a whistle, the backpack has a whistle, and then I have a separate whistle here that you can put around your neck. And then in this part, I have a portable phone charger. Now you want to make sure that this is charged and you have the right cables for it. I usually have my phone next to my bed almost always. I mean, if I don't, I'm not sure why I wouldn't. So, and then I also have a charging station there. So usually my phone is charged at night, but you want to just have this in case you're in, have to go to a shelter or, you know, you're away from outlets. So you have something to charge your phone with. And then I have extra keys for our two cars. So you can usually get a valet key. This one just happens to be broken, but this is an extra set of keys. You can get a valet key. Now for other cars, like my one car, it cannot have a valet car. So you have to get a second or third one like this. And this does get expensive. So just kind of consider that. And then I have a debit card here. You can also put cash. I do need to put cash in here. I'd say at least $100 because if you have to go to a hotel or motel for the night, for a few nights, you know, insurance isn't gonna kick in right away. So you can have a card that's specifically just for emergencies. Okay, I showed you this that was in here. And then I have a pair of fire resistant gloves and these are great because it has the reflector here. Okay. And then this is a wet and dry bag. I figured I was lucky when we had that apartment fire that the firefighters were allowed us to go back in to grab some clothes and toiletries and things like that for the week, but we weren't allowed to go back until it was completely fixed up. And so I just have here a set of clothes. I just have underwear, a top, and shorts. Depending on your season, you may wanna put pants or even a sweater here or a jacket that's, you know, lightweight but warm, because you have to consider the weight and the capacity of your bag. And then I just have a pair of flip-flops, and then I do have also toothbrush, toothpaste, and some mouthwash, just just very basic convenience and hygiene, okay? So the great thing with this wet and dry bag, so when my clothes are dirty, I can just keep it in here also versus just a regular Ziploc bag. This is also supposed to be water resistant. And then I have this fireproof document holder. They come two in a pack. One is in my husband's bag, one is in mine. And what you wanna put here are the original documents. So hopefully you have multiple copies of original documents like your marriage certificate, birth certificate, have copies of your passports in here and your social security cards. So things that are important that are, you know, you can always get them again, but it just takes more time. So it's important to have those types of documents in here. You may also want to have medical documents that you need to keep for certain members of the family or things for your pets. Okay, this has a pocket here, and this is where I keep the fire blanket. And so you want to look at the size. There are sizes that are meant to just, let's say, throw over your stove to get a fire out. And there are sizes that can actually cover the whole person. And so, of course, those are a little bit more expensive. These can also hang on the wall, and then you could just pull it out from under here. So here at the bottom, I just have this family burn care kit. And the great thing is that all over Amazon, the big box stores, there are different types of kits already made. So this is, for me, worth just getting this. You can see what it contains in here. And it's worth it to me to get something that's already put together. It has a box, it has the basic things that you need, and it's specifically for a burn care. And in this pocket, I have this water gel, sterile gel soaked burn dressing. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it informative. Let me know what you have in your home fire emergency go bag, or what you would add to this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought we'd never pay the price.